can claim a record of good leadership and administration. Few claim to have reshaped their country's future so decisively under the guidance of the custodians of the two holy wars. His Royal Highness is succeeding in doing both. I sincerely hope that the innovative and ambitious project featured in the Saudi Vision 2030 and the ones announced at the Future Investment Initiative Conference will provide opportunities to cooperation between our two countries. Mauritius has the ability and the determination to grasp any opportunity that presents to him. This has been proven time and again. The country is currently undergoing vast development, with our main project being the Metro Express. Similar to Saudi leadership, the Mauritian leadership is taking bold steps to take Mauritius to the next level of development.
We are opening a consulate here in Mauritius also to further enhance the contact. We are encouraging our business community to come and visit and to invest. We're looking at investment opportunities in Mauritius. You may be a small country, but you have a big heart. And you have been able, through determination, through creativity, through energy, and through wise policies, to overcome adversity. You have moved from being an underdeveloped country to being a high-income country. You have educated your people, you have built your infrastructure, and you have carved out a role for yourself in the world that is much, much larger than your physical size, and for that you deserve credit. The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia values Mauritius. We value our political consultations with Mauritius, and we value the cooperation that exists among us in international arenas, whether in the United Nations, whether our joint efforts in Africa, whether in trying to promote peace and stability around the world, and we look forward to further strengthening and broadening and deepening those ties in all areas. I expect that you will see more Saudis come and visit, and I expect that as more come, they will tell their friends and family, and more will also come. We now have inaugurated direct airline service between the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and Mauritius that began in the fall with 3 flights a week. I expect that the number will increase, and I expect that the number of trade and investments will also increase between our two countries. I know that everybody is hungry, and I don't want to take up your time or keep you from giving your meal, but I want to once again thank you for the hospitality afforded to myself and my colleagues. I want to thank you for your friendship. I want to thank your great nation for its partnership with the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. When you think of it, the people who discovered Mauritius were Arabs. We have ethnic ties, we have religious ties, we have trade ties, we have political ties. I think we have all the elements to build a truly great relationship between our two countries. My brother Shoukat talked about intolerance and promoting dialogue, and my monarch, the custodian of the two holy mosques, Salman bin Abdul Aziz, is committed to pursuing an agenda of openness, an agenda of dialogue.
And more recently, the kingdom graciously offered a grant of $10 million to the government of Mauritius to finance several initiatives of our choice. In fact, when we met this afternoon, His Excellency told me that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia would further give another $10 million to help us for the event that we have here in the city center. Which is, I must say, an act of kind-heartedness and generosity that will be engraved in the history of the brotherly relationship between our two nations. Distinguished guests, for years, the proposal for the opening of an embassy in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia had been mooted, but unfortunately was never materialized. I understand that Your Excellency has been instrumental in the decision taken by your government to exceptionally increase the Hajj quota for Mauritius to 1,500 for the past 3 years. We are extremely grateful to Your Excellency for this gesture, and of course we can only hope that consideration will be given for a further increase in the future. I also wish to extend my profound appreciation towards all the persons and organizations who were involved in Mauritius in the organization of Hajj 2017. And each one of you has fulfilled its responsibility with patience, enthusiasm, and piety. I am now personally following up on all the matters relevant to this year's Hajj. Distinguished guests, we will also recall that in June last year, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia supported Mauritius at the United Nations General Assembly by voting in favor of our resolution requesting for an advisory opinion of the International Court of Justice on the legal consequences of the separation of the Chagos Archipelago from Mauritius before its accession to independence. We are grateful to your government for its unwavering commitment to support Mauritius in our endeavor to complete our decolonization. I have no doubt that your country will remain engaged when proceedings in this matter will start at the International Court of Justice. I also